Hey you guys, it's Christina, and today I'm going to be talking about 10 simple ways to boost your immune system. There's lots of talk lately about viruses and sickness, and my inbox has been full with people asking me what they can do to boost their immune systems and to keep themselves protected. So that's exactly what we're going to be talking about today. I've also just created a blog post on my website at fullyrod.com covering this topic with all of the written points, just in case any of you want to reference my notes there as well. I just want to add a disclaimer to this video to let you know that I am not a doctor and I'm not prescribing any specific advice to anyone here. I'm merely sharing my thoughts and suggestions from what I've learned via my own personal experience on my 14-year journey of being a fully raw vegan, in hopes that these tips might be helpful to you in some way. Some doctors I recommend you check out are Dr. Garth Davis, Dr. Michael Greger, T. Colin Campbell, and many more. There are some amazing book suggestions and links below for you in the description of this video. I also recommend checking out the CDC website for more current facts, especially ones regarding the coronavirus or flu or other illnesses. The CDC is recommending people to wash their hands frequently, disinfect properly, stay away from large crowds for the moment in time, and even to drink more water. Older adults are at a higher risk, as are individuals with heart disease, diabetes, or lung disease. I recommend keeping tabs of credible sources instead of always watching news outlets that tend to procreate fear and more fear. We don't need to be living in fear, and for that reason, I'm making this video so that you can take some actions and steps to feel empowered. For those looking for an immunity-boosting drink, please check out the cold and flu juice shot I posted on my channel just last week. That juice recipe is amazing. And it has all of the essentials to help you recover from a cold, the flu, or even just clear out mucus. Go check it out, and I'll put some links below for you, or you can just check it out on my channel. If you haven't already, please hit the subscribe button because there is only more epicness to come, and I have a really huge announcement coming later this week, so please stay tuned. All right, so let's jump into this video and get into 10 simple ways that you can boost your immune system. Are you ready? I'll try not to get too long-winded on these. Here we go. My number one is to get enough sleep and to properly manage stress. Sleep deprivation and stress overload can increase the hormone cortisol in your body, which can actually suppress your immune function. Getting enough sleep also helps your body to rebuild and restore properly. Not getting enough sleep can wear down on your immune system and can eventually cause adrenal fatigue, which can lead to other health issues. Also, I think there are too many people who don't see stress as a big deal, but it's a huge deal. It wears down your defenses and makes you more susceptible to not feeling well. So while stress and sleep might be two things that are overlooked most often, or maybe even brushed aside, I actually feel that they are probably two of the most prominent things that you can focus on to help keep yourself protected and to keep your immune system strong. So be sure to get enough sleep and to try and reduce the amount of stress you have as much as possible. My number two, avoid tobacco smoke. Unfortunately, there are still a lot of people who smoke, yes, even in 2020, I know many of you watching my videos might be more health conscious and perhaps this one doesn't apply to you. However, there might still be people around us who smoke or environments where we find ourselves being exposed to smoke. Smoking undermines our basic immune defenses and it raises the risk of bronchitis and pneumonia in everyone. It even increases our chance of getting an ear infection. It's not good for your lungs, and it makes you more susceptible to health issues all around. Number three, drink less alcohol and drink way more water. Even drink more green juice. Excessive consumption of alcohol impairs your immune system, and it increases vulnerability to lung infections. The CDC is recommending for people right now to drink more water as to flush out any toxins out of the system and out of the esophagus as much as possible. I love green juice for all of the nutrients and benefits that it offers to our body, and I cannot recommend it enough as a solid immunity booster. My next suggestion is to eat plenty of fruits, vegetables, nuts, and seeds. Go vegan. Consume as many nutrients as you can via fiber-rich foods, via colorful, life-giving foods. Stop consuming animal products and start finding replacements for meat or dairy. This will provide your body with the nutrients your immune system needs. I posted a video not too long ago called 5 Reasons to Go Vegan, and this video goes into more depth for you about this topic. And since we're discussing nutrition here, I recommend focusing on consuming more vitamin C, as it is widely known to be beneficial for your immune system. It's an essential micronutrient for humans that has antioxidant properties that support the immune system on a cellular level. Studies have shown that vitamin C can prevent and even treat systemic infections in the body, and many foods naturally contain vitamin C, and you can also take it in a supplement form. Some of the foods with the highest vitamin C content include citrus fruits, mango, papaya, berries, bell peppers, tomatoes, all leafy greens, and broccoli. My next suggestion, take probiotics. It's important to keep your gut healthy when talking about building up your immune system. Did you know that your gut, or your microbiome, is the center of your immune system? Your microbiome can contain both harmful and helpful bacteria. Your helpful bacteria would be your probiotic bacteria. Probiotics are considered beneficial bacteria, and studies suggest that they can help regulate the immune system in a way that can both prevent and treat immune response related diseases, such as allergies, eczema, and viral infections. It's important to keep a healthy level of good bacteria in the gut so it will prevent the overgrowth of bad bacteria. The overgrowth of harmful bacteria is what contributes to disease, and a lack of beneficial bacteria can make you more susceptible to infection. Consuming probiotics can give your body beneficial bacteria in order to boost the immune system as a whole. So probiotics can be taken in supplement form as well as through food, and some of the food sources that contain probiotics that I happen to love are kombucha, sauerkraut, kimchi, and kefir. Get some sunshine and soak up that vitamin D. Sunlight triggers the skin's production of vitamin D. Low vitamin D levels correlate with a greater risk of respiratory infection. A 2010 study in kids showed that 1,200 IUs a day of supplemental vitamin D reduced the risk of influenza. Now, I know that not everyone has access to sunshine at the moment, since we're just now transitioning out of our winter months. So perhaps if you're interested, you can find a good vitamin D supplement, and I have one linked below for you in this video that I absolutely love and I am currently taking myself. My next suggestion, consume more garlic. Garlic is a broad spectrum antimicrobial agent and immune booster. I recommend adding it into your salad dressings and juices, as I showed you in my juice recipe I mentioned at the beginning of this video. And an interesting fact about garlic is that it used to be hung in houses to keep the vampires away. Right? It's that powerful. There is a component in garlic called allicin, I hope I said that right, that is known for its antibacterial properties. In fact, garlic has been used to fight infectious diseases for centuries due to its abilities to be resistant to multiple different types of bacteria, including Salmonella and E. coli. Garlic also has the properties to differentiate between beneficial bacteria and harmful bacteria in the gut, because garlic is a prebiotic. A prebiotic brings balance to the gut flora by inhibiting growth of harmful bacteria. Not only is garlic antibacterial, but studies have shown that it also has antiviral properties as well. Because different illnesses can be caused by viruses, bacteria, or harmful microbes, garlic pretty much covers everything. Garlic is most powerful in its raw form, so it still contains all of the antimicrobial properties That is exactly why I recommend that you add it to your juices or your salad dressings. I think it actually tastes pretty amazing in juices. Next up, a suggestion would be to consume more medicinal mushrooms, such as shiitake, reishi, lion's mane, turkey's tail, cordyceps, and maitake. A recent study showed that medicinal mushrooms can actually enhance your immune function, especially in women with breast cancer. There's so much information out there on consuming medicinal mushrooms. No, I'm not talking about smoking it. I'm talking about consuming it, whether in a tea or powdered form. Give it a Google. You might be surprised at what you find. Start supplementing your diet and consuming more herbs. Herbs like echinacea, elderberry, rose hips, andrographis, and astragalus can help reduce the duration and severity of illness. On top of that, supplementing your diet with extra vitamins or minerals can help provide the necessary nutrients for a strong immune system. And as of recent, I absolutely have to tell you that I love the supplements from Symbiotica. They just came out with the absolute best B12 and vitamin D supplements tailored for vegans, and I love them. They've created an amazing line of products, and I have them linked below and even on my website now. I also love Sun Warrior's products and their cellular health bundle. No, this is not sponsored. I'm genuinely sharing with you what I'm currently using and love. My last and final tip would be to start using therapeutic grade essential oils. Essential oils are powerful, and I think they shouldn't be ignored in moments like this. Essential oils that have antiviral and antibacterial properties to them are clove, frankincense, lemon, eucalyptus, rosemary, cinnamon, and tea tree oil. You can diffuse these in your home, so you can carry them with you and rub them on you when necessary. You can rub them on your hands and use them as disinfectants. You can even bathe in them. I always have my essential oils in my bag, and if you watch my Instagram stories, I'm always putting essential oils in my face mask when I travel on planes. I think essential oils are essential, and I have some links for you below as to the ones that I most recommend. I hope you all have enjoyed this video. If you have, please be sure to give it a thumbs up and also hit the subscribe button. If you have other things that you'd like to do that help to boost your immune system, please leave it in the comments below. I'm sure we'll all love to read what suggestions that you might have to bring to the table as well. For those of you who are interested in the blog post about this topic, the link to my website is below for you. And please don't forget, for those of you who are interested, my 2020 Fully Raw Retreat signups are happening right now. So if you're interested in coming to a retreat with me in Bali or St. Lucia, you can check out the details below or email me at retreats@fullyraw.com, and I will absolutely love to welcome you there. All right, you guys, I have a big announcement coming for you later this weekend, so please stay tuned, and I can't wait to see you all in my next video. Sending you all my hugs and my love.
Christina knows how to fill your belly. So following her YouTube channel and